Hi everyone, my name's Rita and I'm from Arcadium, the creators behind the world's most played games. Today we're going to explore three advanced Sudoku techniques. The techniques I'm going to show you today will be most helpful for players who have been playing Sudoku for a while and are ready to start tackling more difficult puzzles. However, whatever level you're at, I've shared a link to the game in the description below if you want to play along now or later. As you know, Sudoku is a number puzzle game where you need to rely on your logic and process of elimination to succeed. The goal is to fill every row, column, and square on the grid with the numbers 1 through 9. There's a catch though. You can't repeat any number in a row, column, or square. So while it may be tempting to guess which number goes where, you should use the process of elimination instead. Now with all that said, let's dive into three advanced techniques for solving Sudoku puzzles. First off, let's try the Xwing method. This method is used to eliminate potential candidates for a specific cell. It's used when you can spot a rectangle formed by a single candidate in your notations. Either parallel pairs of sides on the rectangle must have the candidate in exactly two spots for this method to work. Here we can see a rectangle formed by the number 5 that we can use to try the Xwing method. The corners of the rectangle form a pair of solutions that are the only possible location for 5s. Drawing lines between them puts the X in our Xwing. Now, all other possible 5s in our notes that share a row or column with our rectangle can be eliminated. Let's take a look at our yellow pair to see why that is. If we put a 5 in the bottom left yellow corner here, our red and green cells are eliminated because now they share a row or column with this new 5. Then our yellow corner is the only remaining space for the other 5. And if we start from this other yellow 5 instead, we can still eliminate the red 5 because we know there must be a 5 in row E. Next, we have the swordfish method. Just like the Xwing method, this is used to eliminate a candidate from specific cells. But instead of using two rows or columns like the Xwing, the swordfish uses three rows or columns. Think of it like overlapping rectangles without the intersecting lines. In this example, we can see that the number 4 makes the shape we need to apply the swordfish. Just like with the X-wing, we end up with a pair of solutions for our 4s. So we can once again eliminate any other notes that share a row or column with our shape. And finally, let's explore the forcing chains method. Unlike the X-wing and swordfish methods, forcing chains will allow you to find a definitive solution for a cell. But it can take some legwork. The forcing chains methods require you to spot a pair of cells that are indirectly affected by one another. The idea is to find a situation where all possible options in the first cell result in the same outcome in the second cell. Here we see this playing out between the orange cells, where we can apply the forcing chains method. When testing for both digits, you'll find that the solution for the other orange cell with candidates 5 and 7 is always 5. So therefore, 5 is the solution for that particular cell. If we were to put a 1 in our top orange cell, it forces a 4 in this next cell, which forces a 7 in this cell over here. And that forces the 5 in our other orange cell. In short, if this cell is a 1, then this cell must be a 5. The key here is that if we apply the same process with the 2, the other still has to be a 5. As you can see, it can sometimes be a long chain, but the result is the same. So because all possible options for our first cell result in a 5, we know that our second cell must be 5. And there you have it, three advanced techniques for solving Sudoku puzzles. Let us know if this video was helpful or if you pick up any new tips or tricks as you play. If you enjoyed this video or would like to see more advanced Sudoku techniques, please leave a comment, like, and subscribe to Arcadium on YouTube. Also, please click the bell icon to get notifications about new videos. Thanks for watching and have fun playing!